Good afternoon. Good afternoon again, and welcome again to this lecture of electronics, in which I guess we were studying, say, the applications of diode, and we have almost completed all sorts of diodes application like rectifiers, clippers, and clampers. Today, we in the last class we have completed all about the peak inverse voltage and say efficiency and all sorts of derivations and formulas which are required for half wave rectifier. So we have analyzed the half wave rectifier circuit in that. And today we are going to continue with the same for the say full wave rectifier. So let me share my screen and let me introduce myself. Yeah, it's visible. Is it visible now? My screen is visible to you? Anybody can unmute and let me know, please. So let me introduce myself, Dr. N.D. Meshram, Head and Associate Professor, Department of Electronics, Shri Mathura Das Mohota College of Science, Nagpur. And today, as I told you, we are going to study more about, the full wave rectifier circuit. I guess it is visible. So we are going to analyze of the full wave rectifier. My sound is not okay. Okay, now it is okay. So we are going to optimize the full wave rectifier circuit, and let us start. So I guess you know what is full wave rectifier circuit. We have studied that. So just for say a revision purpose, we can start with that. So this is say half wave rectifier. Yeah. So full wave rectifiers are of two types: center tap rectifier and a bridge rectifier. So this is the center tap rectifier, means the transformer is having a center tapping. So we are having the secondary as S1, S and S2, right? So secondary is having center tapping. So we are expecting the voltage with respect to say the central terminal, that is S. Okay, so this is the full wave rectifier, which is employing two diodes in there. So one of the diode remains in forward bias during the positive half, and the other diode remains in conduction during the negative half. So the whole of the wave is being rectified, and therefore it is called as the full wave center tap full wave rectifier circuit. So this is what we have studied, and this is actually the waveform that we get out of this rectifier circuit. So in the input is given like this. So we are having this sine wave, which starts from zero, then it reaches to pi, that is 180 degrees, and at 180 degree it switches to negative half, and then it remains for in the negative half during this 2 pi region. After that 2 pi, it will again continue up to 3 pi. And after 3 pi, it will again remain at the negative half up to 4 pi. And similarly, it will go on repeating itself. So the next, say, phase angle will be that. So we are taking the amplitude versus the phase angle. Phase angle is on the x-axis and the amplitude is on the y-axis. Okay, so this is the sine wave, how it proceeds. And if you apply this voltage to the rectifier circuit, full wave, center tap, full wave rectifier circuit, we are expecting to get this type of pulses. So we call it as a pulsating DC. It is not pure DC still, right? So during this region, the D1 conducts, during the another type, the D2 will conduct, similarly D1 and D2. So alternately, one of the diode will remain in forward bias, and we will be getting half of the cycle. So all the full wave is being rectified. So that is why it is called as a full wave rectifier circuit. And so this is the amplitude which is supposed to be represented over here as Vm. So Vm is the maximum amplitude of the voltage which is being applied. So we get this. Now, peak inverse voltage, since we are using diodes, so the peak inverse voltage of a diode is twice of Vm. Okay, so that is the maximum voltage. Okay, and this is the another circuit that we are having, is a bridge rectifier. And here we are employing again four diodes, right? So these four diodes in this bridge circuit, two diodes work at a time. Okay, so this is over there, and the peak inverse voltage. Yes, ripple factor, efficiency. Yeah, so we have this. So I guess we are center tapped, and then this is a bridge rectifier. So in the bridge rectifier circuit, two of the diodes will work during positive half, and the other two diodes will remain reverse bias. During the next negative half, another two diodes are going to conduct and will be having full wave coming out of it. So we'll be having D2, D3, D1, D4, D2, D3, and D1, D4 like this. And we'll be having the full wave coming across the output of the rectifier circuit. Okay, so the peak inverse voltage, since we have used two diodes again, so it will remain in that. So twice peak inverse in, say, the center tab or say in the full wave bridge rectifier will be having VM. Sorry, in say bridge rectifier, we are having VM, and in that center tab full wave rectifier, we are having that voltage equal to twice of VM, right? So here it is written over here, twice of VM. That is the maximum ripple factor. The purpose of a rectifier is to convert AC voltage to a DC, but not type of a rectifier. No rectifier converts AC to pure DC. It produces pulsating DC. This residual pulsation is called as ripple, and the ripple factor indicates the effectiveness of the rectifier in converting AC to perfect DC. It is the ratio of ripple factor to the DC voltage. That is what we have studied in the last class, right? So here, the say ripple factor in half wave rectifier is given as 1.21, whereas it has been reduced in full wave rectifier 0.482, right? Since we are having full wave is rectified over there, so this can be derived like we have derived in this in the equation of say half wave rectifier. Okay, so this is say ripple factor, and then we are having efficiency. So efficiency of a rectifier is a measure of conversion of AC power to the useful DC output power. It is expressed as the ratio of DC output power to the AC input power. We have already studied this equations. So these are the values of that. For half wave rectifier, neta should be equal to 14.6. And since we are using two diodes at a time in full wave and say bridge rectifier circuit, so it is twice of this efficiency of the half wave rectifier. That will come out to be around 81.2%. Right, so the efficiency is also increased in full wave rectifier circuit. This is the sample problem that we can study over here, and we can understand how we can calculate these things. Right, so in a full wave center tap rectifier, the load resistance used is of 2 kilo ohms. The forward resistance of each diode is around 400 ohm. The voltage across the half of the secondary winding is 240 sine of 50 t. Right, so find IM, IDC, IRMS, ripple factor, and PIB. So this is what we have to calculate, right? So for IM, the first one is IM is equal to VM divided by RD plus RL. So this is the equation of that IM. So IM will be equal to, since VM is already given over there, this is 240 sine of omega t, right? So VM sine omega t is there. So if you compare this equation, 240 sine 50 t, then you will be able to get VM. So VM is equal to 240 volts, and then RD and RD plus RL. RL is given as say 400 ohms, whereas load resistance is given as 2 kilo ohms, and the series resistance of the diode is taken as 400 ohms, right? So we are substituting those values over here. So IM will be equal to 240 divided by 400 plus 2000 ohms. If you say solve it, then the output current, that is IM, maximum current that is supposed to come across this rectifier circuit, will be equal to say 1 ampere. Is it okay? I guess it is say 0.1 ampere like. So I guess my voice is clear. Am I audible? Anybody can unmute and let me. Yes, am I audible? Hello?
Am I audible? Sir.
हाँ मेरा आवाज वहाँ दिखा नहीं रहा.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So IM is equal to VM by RD plus RL. This is how you can calculate the maximum current flowing through this coming out of this rectifier. Then IDC. IDC is calculated as twice of IM by pi. These equations are nearly equal of half wave and full wave rectifier. So just go through those derivation portion of it. So it is equal to twice into 0.1 divided by pi, and that comes out to be say 0.636 ampere, that is 63.6 milliamperes, right? So just divided by 1000, so you'll be getting that. So it is 63.6 milliamperes. Actually it is 0.636 ampere So no, it should come around more than this. So it should be 636 milliamperes. Okay. So IRMS will be equal to, IRMS equal to, the formula is IM divided by root 2. If you divide it by root 2, 0.1, you will get 70.72 milliamperes. Yes, this is right. I get this is one decimal point should be shifted. It is 636 milliamperes. Okay. So this is how you are going to calculate IM, IDC and IRMS. And in the next, we are having the same derivation as ripple factor. So ripple factor can be calculated as the formula we have already studied. Gamma is equal to under root of IRMS divided by IDC whole square minus 1. Okay. So if you say solve it, so it comes out to be say 0.501 or say 50.1%. That is the ripple factor. And PIV, as we have already given the formula for center tap transformer, it is equal to twice of VM. So VM is 240. So PIV will be equal to 480 volts, peak inverse voltage. Okay. So this is all about, say, the full wave bridge rectifier circuit. I guess with this, we have completed this unit. And if you have any queries on this, you can ask me anytime. So we have, today we have studied this full wave rectifier circuit. And this was half wave rectifier circuit in which we have calculated or derived some formulas like this. Right. So I have uploaded that video on my YouTube. So you can go through that YouTube video and you can check on yourself how you have derived those formulas. So this is what we have studied in the last class. Yeah. So this is how we have started with the formulas like this. And we have calculated IDC is equal to twice of IM. Accordingly, we get the values of VM, IM and VDC, like, so this, the same thing is to be repeated for say full wave bridge rectifier. So do you have any questions on this? Hello, am I audible or have you understood? Yeah, today we have done this analysis of full wave rectifier and we have already seen this. So circuits we have seen, we have two types of full wave rectifier, center tap rectifier and bridge rectifier. This is center tap full wave rectifier, in which two diodes are there and one diode conducts at a time. So we'll be having D1, D2 conducting alternately and we'll be having full wave coming out of it. So bridge rectifier is also there. And in the bridge rectifier, two diodes at a time work and the other two diodes remain, say, in reverse bias. So they don't work. They act as an open switch. Okay, still we are able to get the full wave over, out of it. So peak inverse voltage for a bridge rectifier circuit is VM. Ripple factor is given as, say, for half wave rectifier, it is 1.21. For full wave rectifier, we can calculate, we can derive it, say, around 0.482, right? Similarly, for efficiency is double of, say, half wave rectifier, it is around 81.2. And this is a simple problem in which we have to calculate IM, IDC, IRMS, ripple, and peak inverse voltage. So these are the formulas, and this is how it should be calculated. So I guess this much is enough for the unit and hopefully we have completed this unit. Yeah. So thank you very much for joining. Stay tuned to my YouTube channel, go through my YouTube channel, please like, share, subscribe my channel and thank you very much for joining. Stay home, stay safe, take care. See you in the next class. Bye. Good day.